I'm pleased to be able to, we were able to arrange this ceremony, and I'd like to welcome you, members of the family, friends, members of the Congress who are here today. Joe is to me, as I think he is to all Americans, a national hero. He became a hero at a time when our nation was in need of one. A great inspiration and hope. The pleasure that he's given us is just the beginning of a long list of contributions that he made to his country. He'll be remembered, of course, for his incredible boxing record, a career that included defending his title, world heavyweight champion 25 times, and a great many champions have not risked losing their title that much. And he held the title from 1937 until 1948. He'll also be remembered for breaking the barrier of racial segregation in professional sports, selflessly enlisting in World War II at the prime of his career, holding that title. And incidentally, it should be known that he defended that title sometimes as a $54 a month private, in which all of the proceeds went to Army emergency relief. And none to him, and he could have lost the title, as anyone could imagine at that time. He didn't, though. But he has been buried in Arlington National Cemetery, and I knew Joe personally. I had been a sports announcer at my beginning, first met him at that time. And we met again. He was a private, and I was a second lieutenant in the war, and both of us were sent from wherever we were serving to Warner Brothers Studio to appear at our Army salaries. Not at any picture salaries. In a picture called This is the Army, written by Irving Berlin, and the proceeds of which all went to Army emergency relief. But I think a lot of people will remember a night in Madison Square Garden. And it was a war bond rally, and all the greats of show business and public life were there, including the stage and this great audience in Madison Square Garden. And there was a lot of talk, of course, about God being on our side. And Private Joe Lewis was introduced by Georgie Jessel, and walked out on the stage and said one sentence that got a tremendous standing ovation. When he was the only one, the first one there, to say, I know we'll win because we're on God's side. So today I'm happy again to show this nation's deep appreciation to a man who was and still is an inspiration to all Americans by presenting to you this old man's day.
I know Joe would love to be here to receive this honor, but now that he's gone, his memory lingers on, and we'll never forget him. And as paraphrased by the president, when Joe said at Madison Square Garden, we'll win because we're on God's side. We'll win because of God's side. They're having a program in Detroit for Joe's birthday. Do you mind having a picture of his son? We're having a dinner someday.
Very pleased to.
And his friend, this is the old time secretary.
I was there when he made that statement.
You were?
Thank you, sir.
Well, it's nice to see you. Congratulations.
And if you'd like to meet my family, these are my two sons, James and Michael. Michael's the redhead.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
My husband, Ken.
Hello there.
And daughter, Angela.
Well, hi.
You're being very sleepy right now.
Anne is going to be fascinated by those cameras.
Actually, she'll learn to ignore them this time.
Yes.
It is a genuine honor to meet you, not because you happen to be pressed right now. We've supported you from day one, and we will continue to do so.
Thank you very much.
You're not perfect. None of us are.
Listen, and I wish you well in Honolulu. I know you're on the way there for the first contest.
I think that'll be great. I think married women have the broadest sphere of influence in the world. You know, they just reach all aspects of the world. So I think it might be kind of socially significant getting married, ladies. Well, I think they run the whole program.
I'll go along with that.
Okay, let's go, guys.
Why don't you come around and why don't we have a group family picture here?
And Angela's picking her nose. Is that
Thank you, gentlemen.
It's good to see you guys, too.
I understand you've been making a lunch in your honor in Charlotte.
Oh, yeah. I would much rather be here.
I hope they'll understand.
Absolutely.
I'm pleased to have you here. Express my admiration for what you've done. And what goodwill has done. Piedmont Community College. All of it played a part in this.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. President, I'd like to introduce Mrs. Fischera, National Auxiliary President of the Italian American War Veterans.
Nice to see you.
Mr. President,
nice to see you.
Mr. DePrima,
how do you do,
past
Mr.
President?
Mr. President, nice to see you.
Thank you, sir.
We're delighted to be here this morning.
Well, I'm very proud to see you on the board. Americans
sitting this side, so I can
read it. Italian extraction are a great part of the American life.
Thank you.
American life.
Thank you.
As a matter of fact, for a number of years in my ranch, my partner in the ranch was a former captain of the Italian cavalry in Italy, Nino Pepitone. And I ride a Periani saddle. The forward seat, which was created by an Italian named Captain Caprivi in 1905 in Italy, which has been adopted all over the world as the proper seat for riding, jumping, and so forth.
I want you to know that you certainly have our support as a veterans organization, as a group, personally.
Well, I appreciate
we're very proud
that.
Of you today.
We're from Massachusetts, and no one thinks for us but ourselves. You can enjoy your life.
Jeff Bell, Citizens.
Jeff,
how are you?
Rhonda Stoneman, Conservative Alliance.
See
you. Gary Jarman, Christian Voice.
Mark Holtzman, Citizens for America.
Mark,
yes. Curtis Mack, Citizens for the Republic.
Bob Hickman, Fund for a Conservative Majority.
Third Golden, Nick Hack.
Yes.
Vicki Evers, Chairman of ACU.
Name again?
Ted Fennell, Christian Broadcasting Network's Freedom Council.
Henry Walter with the United States Defense Committee. Ron Godwin, Dr. Falwell.
Ron Robinson, Young Americans Foundation.
Tom Ritter, Human
Rights.
John Fisher, American Security Council.
Amy Moritz, National Center for Public Policy Research.
Greg Butler, Coalition for America.
Jack Abramoff, College of Public Policy.
Well, this is Joey Schultz, Secretary of State.
Sorry to be late. I just had a little ceremony over at the State Department honoring the Marines who guard our embassies. And each year the outstanding detachments are picked, and we had a little ceremony honoring them. The Marine band played, and boy, I'm all set up.
Well, my day got a little crowded, but also was given a gold medal that Congress has approved to the widow of Joe Lewis, former world champion. I knew him back in the days when I was a sports announcer, later in Hollywood in the Army, when We were both in that. But I know that you're being briefed on some of the things. I just want to say here that I want to thank so many of you for what your people and your followers did in following Wednesday night's speech and the outpouring that I think led to quite a happy result yesterday up in the Congress. But if Bud hasn't said this to you already, we still need you and we need all the support we can get from Congress, because while they passed an authorization, they did not pass an appropriation. And this could still die in a matter of, it would be there in paper, but there wouldn't be any money to back it up. So we're going to have to, and we think we still will. Those who nearly defeated us and who were so strong are undoubtedly going to try to head us off the appropriation path. So we'll take all the help and support we can get in this. I know that you're aware that, I'm sure you are, that our policy in Central America is one that we think is long overdue, and that it does involve not only providing security for people who are trying to bring about democratic reforms there, but it involves eliminating, if we can, over a period of time, the causes that have made them so susceptible to subversion and influences of that kind. Up until now, and for, I guess, a century or more, most of the revolutions are, well, all but the one in El Salvador, I think, generally have taken the form of simply exchanging one set of rulers for another set of rulers. And at last we've got a toehold for democracy there. And I think it is in our national and the world interest for us to move on that. We can't ask greater reforms than we have obtained so far, as long as they're doing it under fire and being shot at. As I pointed out in my speech, land reform doesn't mean very much. If the farmer that gets the land knows he can't go out and cultivate it, he'll get shot by a gorilla hiding in the bushes. But I don't want to keep on talking here, and I know our time is limited, so.
Mr. President.